I had heard from so many sources that people with diabetes could not or should not exercise. I had discussed that with my doctor, and he said, that's a bunch of nonsense.
I think in order to conquer diabetes, you're gonna have to exercise. The only way you're really gonna get that A1C count down is to move around. You have to move when you got diabetes.
I don't like to exercise, but what I've discovered when I exercise, I feel better, and it's very good for you, and it helps keep your numbers down in terms of your glucose levels.
Found out that it really does make a difference, diet and exercise. I used to wonder why they used to emphasize that, and then I stopped eating as much as I used to, and I didn't lose the weight that I thought I would lose by just not eating. So then I started exercising, and I noticed that my weight did come down, and I did feel better. So exercise with the diet does make a difference.
Hello, I'm Dr. Regina Benjamin, United States Surgeon General. Welcome to this program on physical activity for people with type 2 diabetes. Along with diet, medication, and testing your blood sugar, exercise is crucial to managing your glucose. In fact, it's just as important as the pills or the insulin you take.
People with diabetes often have to take multiple medicines to control their blood sugar, their blood pressure, their blood cholesterol, and that can be very inconvenient. And some doctors have talked about a polypill, where all of those medicines would be rolled into one pill, taken once a day, and make it easier for the patient. But if you think about it, exercise is the ideal polypill because it helps to lower the sugar, the cholesterol, and the blood pressure. And if people were more active, it's very possible that they can reduce the real pills they have to take, or perhaps even eliminate them altogether.
If you have type 2 diabetes, exercise can help you in a number of ways. Blood sugar, also known as glucose, is a primary fuel for muscles as they do their work. Physical activity helps the muscles use the glucose instead of letting it build up in the blood. Lowering blood sugar improves your heart health and protects your eyes, your feet, your nerves, and your kidneys.
Physical activity keeps your joints and bones healthier and helps control your blood pressure, cholesterol, and weight. It also makes you feel better and improves your quality of life.
Now that I am maintaining an exercise regimen, I'm not as tired as I used to be.
I'm moving more and I have more energy. And I'm not coming home in the evening falling asleep on the bed.
I began to notice that I could sleep better at night. In fact, I needed a little bit less sleep.
I found that since I've exercised, my blood sugars are lower and my insulin usage is down. And I think that's a good thing, you know.
People who should be screened before starting an exercise program who have diabetes are those who are over the age of 40 and have at least two cardiovascular disease risk factors like high blood pressure or high cholesterol, and people who have a family history of premature heart disease. It's important to tell your doctor when you're about to start an exercise program because they may need to make adjustments in your medications. It may also be necessary for them to make adjustments in your meal plan.
It's important to have realistic expectations about activity so you can be most successful. Keep in mind, if you haven't exercised for many, many years, you're not going to become fit overnight or even weeks. It may take several months. So it's important to start slowly, build up over time. Although we set a goal of 30 to 40 minutes a day, the first week you might only be able to do 10 minutes.
When I started exercising on the elliptical machine, I could only do about 2 minutes. At this point, I can do 20, which is good, because it took a while, because the first day I was thinking, I'm going to die on this machine because, you know, I'm exercising and I'm out of breath and my legs are hurting.
You can break it up into shorter periods of time, for example, 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes at lunchtime, 10 minutes in the afternoon, and then over time, over weeks and months, try to consolidate that so you can go for 30 minutes, 40 minutes nonstop.
Gradually, as the weeks went on, then I was doing 5 minutes, and then I challenged myself to do maybe 7 minutes, and then challenge was 10 minutes, and so after a while, I was doing 20.
You know, I started out with step aerobics because it didn't look that hard to me. But once I got into it, I found out it was really hard. But it's something I had to just continue to do. And after a while, I just thought of it pretty much as dancing. And I learned to like it.
So it's important to find a form of exercise that you enjoy and so that you can do it consistently, because you'll be more likely to stick to your routine. And exercise, even if you aren't losing weight, is still beneficial for several reasons. It helps to relieve stress, it helps to lower your blood pressure and cholesterol, and it also helps your body to use your diabetes medications better.
Although it's important to choose an activity that's fun, you also need to make sure that the exercise does not harm your health. There are several ways you can keep yourself safe while exercising. Exercise with someone who knows you have diabetes and knows what to do if you have a low blood sugar reaction. Wear a medical ID bracelet that says you have diabetes. Test your blood sugar often so you know how your body reacts to exercise.
There are three different types of physical activity, and they each benefit your body in different ways. Aerobic exercise benefits your heart and lungs. Resistance exercise, also called strength training, builds muscles and increases endurance. And flexibility exercises increase your range of motion. Let's start with aerobic exercise.
There are exercises during which you carry your body weight on your feet, like running or walking, and other types of exercise, like swimming or bicycling, during which your body weight is supported by water or a machine. Both approaches give you the same healthy benefits. They burn calories, improve your heart and circulation, reduce body fat, and improve your muscles' ability to use blood sugar more efficiently.
If you have problems with pain or numbness in your feet, you should consider doing exercises like swimming or bicycling rather than walking or running. Because you're not carrying your weight, these activities are more gentle on your feet and on your joints. Let's look at resistance training, which uses your muscles to generate force. For example, lifting weights or household objects such as cans of soup or bottles of water are a form of resistance training.
Resistance training burns calories, reduces body fat, and increases your metabolism, muscle strength, bone density, and the body's ability to use insulin and burn sugar. To find the right starting weight for you, find something you can lift 12 or 15 times without getting tired. Once 15 lifts become easy, you can go from a half gallon of something to a gallon. Or if you're lifting weights, you can increase the weight by 5 or 10 pounds. No matter what you're lifting, make sure you breathe freely and try not to hold your breath.
Though aerobic exercise should be done more frequently, 3 to 5 times a week, resistance exercise should be done at least twice a week.
If you have an amputation and you're in a wheelchair, you can do some of the same exercises in the wheelchair that you would do in a regular chair. So upper body exercises will still improve your overall health as well as increase your wheelchair mobility.
In addition to aerobics and resistance training, you should also do some flexibility or stretching exercises. Yoga and Tai Chi help maintain balance, and many community centers and gyms offer classes. You can also do this at home.
Stretching keeps the joints healthy. You can use stretching as a warm-up and cool-down for 5 to 10 minutes before and after any type of physical activity.
So stretches can be done almost anywhere, and what a stretch does is move the joint through what we call a range of motion. So the goal is to stretch as long as you can to really flex those joints. And another key factor is to do it slowly. You don't want to bounce, because the bouncing and a sudden jerking action can actually lead to injury, where stretching really is designed to help avoid injury and soreness.
If you have diabetes, there are several other things to think about when you start becoming physically active. Don't ignore pain. Stop if something hurts. Otherwise, you may cause stress or damage to your joints. Examine your feet regularly. With diabetes, you may not feel pain and won't know if you have an injury, like a blister or an ulcer. Drink water before, during, and after exercise so you don't get dehydrated. Have some type of carbohydrate food available, like hard candy or crackers, in case your blood sugar drops. Physical activity can sometimes cause low blood sugar, especially if you don't carefully time your meals, medications, and exercise schedule.
I usually carry either bananas, cracker, or something with me and a bottle of water to help keep my blood sugar levels normal so I don't have a drop. It's important for me to keep mine up because I know once it starts to drop, I start to feel lightheaded.
If you have diabetes and you're exercising, you should be aware of developing blurred vision, confusion, sweatiness that's more than what you would normally have with exercise, or feeling excessively hungry or shaky. Those could all be signs of a low blood sugar, also called hypoglycemia. So if those symptoms occur, you should eat something with simple sugar in it, such as a graham cracker, or drink a drink with simple sugar, such as orange juice.
Ooh, that's nice.
It's important to get specific shoes for exercise because it can help to prevent injury by protecting your feet, your knees, and your hips. And also they provide the appropriate cushioning that you need, which is very different than your everyday sneakers. So it's important to go to a sporting goods store to be specifically fitted for the correct walking and exercise shoes. Check your feet daily when you have diabetes because you may have developed an injury or a lesion, particularly if you have something called neuropathy, where you have nerve damage from diabetes and don't feel when your feet are injured. So the things specifically that you should talk to your doctor about are new cuts or bruises, calluses, redness or swelling, or anything else in your feet that's of concern to you.
It's also helpful to set aside a certain time each week to exercise. For example, if you plan to exercise every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, mark those days on your calendar so you make a real commitment to yourself.
You want to make exercise a habit so it becomes part of your lifestyle routine. In other words, something you do regularly every week. The benefits of exercise are actually fairly short-lived. So if you go out and take a walk, you'll lower your blood sugar. But after a couple of days, it'll go right back up. So it's important to do the exercise on a regular basis so that the benefits are always there.
The best approach to controlling diabetes and preventing its complications are to take all of your medications as your doctor directs, and also to engage in aerobic as well as resistance training as a form of exercise. This not only helps to improve blood sugar, but also lowers blood pressure and blood cholesterol. And it's important to try to do at least some form of exercise every other day.
You don't have to belong to a gym to get the benefits of exercise. You can do little things throughout the day to increase your physical activity. Going up and down stairs is great exercise. Stand up and walk around the house while you're talking on the telephone. Some people find it's more fun and helpful to do it with a partner. The two of you can motivate and encourage each other to stick with whatever type of physical activity you want to do.
I find that exercise, once you make it a part of your regimen, it actually becomes easier. Not only that, it becomes fun.
The more I do it, the more I enjoy it. I really do. So if I don't do it 3 times a week, I really miss it.
Worry about what you're going to do this week and what you're going to do next week. And start with the little steps, and the big steps will take care of themselves in the future.
My waist has gotten a little smaller, but it's still not to the point where I feel comfortable. I have a long ways to go. But I haven't given up, you know. I think I can pull this one off.
Before you know it, it's just an everyday practice. It's like breathing out and breathing in, just something you do.
We hope this program helps you decide to move. Be sure to talk to your own doctor or clinician if you have any questions or concerns about starting to become physically active. Good luck and good health, and have fun.